Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Vplay. And in today's video, I'm going to cover the best Tarkov settings that you can use in order to get the best out of the game. So this will cover the settings from the Nvidia panel, and I will also show you the settings that I use in game as well. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and get started with the video. So first we are going to have a look at this Nvidia control panel settings. So I will show you exactly what are the settings I use. So once you open the Nvidia panel, you need to go to manage 3D settings, and in program settings you will need to select escape from Tarkov. If you don't see it, you can simply go ahead and add it from this drop down, or there is an add button in which you need to search escape from Tarkov.exe, and you can go ahead and select and apply the settings from there. Once you have it, I will tell you what are the settings you need to change. So this has to be application controlled, so all the settings which will be there in the game will be applied. Next is the anti-aliasing FXAA, which should be off. The gamma correction should be on. The anti-aliasing mode should be application controlled next. And then the low latency mode, which is newly introduced in Nvidia, should be on. So this reduces the input lag on your game as well. Then if you have a G-Sync panel, you can go ahead and switch that on your monitor technology. So make sure that it is G-Sync compatible if you have the option. Next, power management mode should be selected to the maximum performance. So it will be selected at optimal power, but you need to use it as maximum performance. Next, you will need to use the highest available. Then for the texture, you need to use the high performance. For the texture filtering, you need to keep it as on. For the thread optimization, if you don't have a hyper threaded chip, you need to switch it off or put it on auto. If it is hyper threaded, then you can switch it on. Then the triple buffering should be off, and the vertical sync should be selected as off as well. So once you have selected or changed all the settings over here, you can go ahead and apply the settings right from here. And then we will move on to the next one. So this is the resolution. So once you are in resolution, it is by default selected as 1920 by 1080. So you need to go ahead and customize and make your own particular settings. So over here I've already made it, but I'll show you how to do it. So just go on create, and if it is 1080, you just need to delete that and write 79. So you need to reduce 1 point, and the refresh rate should not be more than 144 Hz. So keep that in mind before going ahead and changing anything on that. And once you have done that, just pressed on test. So I've already done it, so I'll not do it. So it is 1920 by 79. Remember, you don't need to select the 1920 by 1079, as it should be on your default settings. It should be 1920 into 1080 should be selected and applied. Just it needs to be there for us to change in game. So the next setting should be the adjust desktop color settings. In this, you can adjust the brightness, contrast and the gamma, and the digital vibrance and hue. So you can change all of this from here instead of changing it in game. So once you have done that, the next one is adjust desktop size and position. You need to keep it on no scaling instead of aspect ratio. Next, you need to enable the G-Sync on your PC as well. So we'll go ahead and dive into the game settings. So the game one, you need to make sure that you have selected auto RAM cleaner and the user for physical cores switched off, as these two are not viable. If you have 8 GB or less, you can go ahead and select auto RAM cleaner on that. And if you don't have hyperthreading, I would recommend not to use this particular settings, as this may reduce the FPS onto your game as well. So next one is the graphic settings. In this, you can go ahead and select the 1920 into 79 as the selection we had made in the custom option. And then you can go ahead and use the aspect ratio, which is 16:9, and the V-Sync should be on. And make sure that your screen mode is to full screen. The texture quality I have set it to high. Shadow quality I have set it to low or medium. You can select any one. The shadow LOD quality should be 2.5. Overall visibility is 1,500. So it can be between 1000 to 2000. So you can keep it anywhere that you want. The next one is shadow visibility, which I have kept it to the lowest setting as it is easier to spot PMCs in this setting. The anti-aliasing is set as TAA high. If you have a low-end PC, you can go ahead and set it to FXAA, but I have set it to TAA high. The resampling is at 1x off, and I have not used any of the other settings as downsampling can really make the game look bad. The other one is the HBAO is off, SSR is off, and anti-trospic filtering is off as well. You can put it on per texture as well if you want, but I have switched it to off. The next one is the sharpness, which is you can keep it anywhere that you like. I've kept it at 1.1 if you want to go ahead and do that. The next one is the lobby FPS and the game FPS, which is set to 60 and 120. I've switched off the high quality color as it really reduces the overall graphics onto the game or the FPS onto the game, and rest everything should be switched off. So once you've done that, the post effect settings, I really don't use the post effect settings as it does really reduce the FPS onto the game. But if you really want to look at the dark places, you can use the post effect settings as well. So these are the settings that I used, and in the sound as well, you can go ahead and reduce it to the overall volume to 60. The interface volume is 100, and rest everything you can keep it at 0. So this is the best settings that you can find. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to my channel as I come up with new guide videos every week. If you have any questions or suggestions about this video, you can go ahead and write them down in the comment section below. And I will see you in the next one.